This episode of DNews is brought to you by Squarespace. Surfers think catching a gnarly wave is radical? Well, thanks to some science, we can ride air currents at almost the speed of sound with 200-ton surfboards in the sky. So how's that for radical? Hey, Silver Surfers. Julian here for DNews. British Airways Flight 114 recently made a transatlantic crossing almost an hour quicker than usual and was clocking ground speeds of 745 miles per hour, or nearly 1200 kph. It's been making news because that is a frankly ludicrous speed, considering the speed of sound at that altitude is somewhere around 1100 kph. But when you take into account the airspeed, that is, the speed the airplane is traveling through the air around it, instead of the ground speed, it doesn't actually break the sound barrier, which is a good thing because the Boeing 777 really wasn't designed for that. Fortunately for everyone stuck in coach, the aircraft was riding a particularly ferocious Jetstream that was at times over 320 kilometers per hour. But why do we have Jetstreams? First of all, Jetstreams are not unique to Earth. We've observed them on Jupiter and Saturn, and here on Earth, Jetstreams form in the troposphere, the lowest atmospheric level. And there can be many that swirl and flow and join and split, and most of them head from west to east. So, if you've flown from North America to Europe, you've probably noticed your flight is shorter in that direction. The one you and Flight 114 cruised on is the Northern Hemisphere's polar jet stream. Now, the polar jet streams are from 7 to 12 kilometers up, but each hemisphere also has weaker subtropical jet streams that are 10 to 16 kilometers up. Jet streams form at the boundary layers between warm air and cold air. The higher pressure cold air pushes into the low pressure area, and in the winter, the pressure differences are greater, so you get stronger winds. But the wind doesn't just move in a straight line from the pole to the tropics, because of the Coriolis effect. Basically, the planet spinning underneath the moving air deflects it east. Higher in the troposphere, there's less friction, so these winds can go unbroken for thousands of miles, and voila! Jet stream. Throw in modern air travel, and if you're lucky, you can get where you want to go at almost the speed of sound. Speaking of getting where you want to go, this episode of DNews was brought to you by Squarespace. Squarespace recently launched their latest version of their platform, Squarespace 7, which has a completely redesigned interface, integrations with Getty Images and Google Apps, new templates, and an incredible feature called Cover Pages. Try the new Squarespace at squarespace.com/DNews and enter our offer code DNews at checkout to get 10% off. Squarespace. Start here. Go anywhere. Now, if you don't think I've gone basic enough to explain why there are jet streams, Trace explains air itself over here. Also, you were probably one of those kids who kept asking why all the time, huh? Well, I like it. Keep it up. So, planning a world trip? Would you head westerly to ride the current or east to west to feel like a time traveler? Tough call, but for me, I like cruising into the sunset for hours at a time. Let us know in the comments, and I'll see you next time on DNews.